closer to the official Disco Talent Show, Season 3. Welcome to a brand new season of Burn Down, and welcome to Disco Talent. Today we're going to have a special guest, KSI and Mr. Beast. How are you guys doing today?
Good, good.
I'm great. Ready to just roast this
guy. Oh, okay.
Well, I'm going to be really nice to everyone.
Good. I'm tired of being nice. I really just want to be a fucking dick.
You guys are switching roles then?
Yeah, me and KSI just replaced it.
Yes.
KSI.
Hi, I'm Eden. I am 13 years old. I'm a blood recipient, and this is my family.
So let's do a quick recap for anybody who doesn't know what this is all about. A few months ago, KSI had this big boxing match with another YouTuber called Joe Weller. Which, come on, look at KSI, look at Joe Weller. This was a no-brainer. KSI destroyed the poor guy. And with his belt around his waist, he very smartly called out the Paul brothers.
Jake Paul, Logan Paul, any of the Pauls, I don't care.
Now, Jake and Logan, being the couple of bitches that they are, took advantage of the fact that he said any of the Pauls, and they tried to send their dad to fight KSI for them.
If he wants to fight me, I'm totally on board. I'll whip his ass. Of course, he's not gonna like the idea that he's getting beat up by an old guy.
For real, though, what a bitch move to send your daddy to fight in your place. That's like being the cool kids in high school, bullying people left and right, but as soon as someone challenges them, they're like,
what's all the hair about this?
And it's not even like their dad is this super cool, badass dude. Greg Paul is a washed-up old man who shamelessly rides the coattails of his kid's success. And he also happens to be... Logan was still busy filming dead people and tasing dead rats, and his PR people told him, dude, this is the best thing you can do right now. Go fight KSI and this whole Japan thing will go away. So Logan Paul and KSI signed the contract agreement to fight in August, and KSI's little brother, Danny, somehow gets involved, even though he's nowhere nearly as strong and imposing as his brother. Deji challenges Jake Paul, and Jake is like, hell yeah, I'm gonna fight this scrawny ass kid. Are you kidding me? I get to be part of the KSI fight without any risk of losing whatsoever? Sign me the flip up. And they sign the contract, and thus the four of them are off to the races. Deji versus Jake Paul, leading up to the main fight, KSI versus Logan Paul. And say what you will about any of these guys, but this is a groundbreaking event for YouTube. It's bringing a lot of legitimacy to YouTubers in the eyes of the mainstream public, and it's really interesting to see how it's all going down. Now, a few days ago, they had their first press conference, which, I don't know, does it count as a press conference? All I see is a bunch of kids and this very angry Asian boy that they keep cutting to. Deji comes out and sits on the stool like a good little boy. Jake Paul comes out in his Conor McGregor wannabe suit, starts trashing Deji, who at this point is just contemplating what a mistake this all was. Finally, it dawns on him that he should probably do something. But the villainous snake that is Jake Paul immediately takes charge.
Fuck Jake Paul! Oh, no. Fuck Jake Paul! Oh, no. Fuck Jake Paul! Oh, no. Fuck Jake Paul! Fuck Jake Paul!
This is such a power move by Jake Paul, and even though I dislike him, I gotta respect his commitment and willingness to be the villain in the story. Then he snatches Deji's sunglasses, and the referee guy goes,
I'm gonna personally buy Deji a new pair of glasses. I apologize for that.
Deji, no. This is a mistake. You don't know what you're getting into. And then Jake Paul, seemingly out of nowhere, starts shouting Walmart over and over again.
Walmart!
Okay.
How can you argue with someone who keeps shouting nonsense at you?
Wrong.
That is absolutely
wrong.
Proved over and over again.
Wrong.
Then they bring out KSI. This guy holding his belt is having the time of his life. Deji finally gets a boost of confidence now that his big brother is next to him, and KSI is like, dude, you're embarrassing me. Then Logan Paul comes on stage, and the guy at the podium fist bumps him. Now hold on a second, he didn't fist bump KSI. If I didn't know any better, I would say that this guy is part of the Low Gang. KSI trying to look all stoic and menacing, but he just looks like he's doing a duck face. Logan Paul takes out his best stand-up material.
Looks like you grew a little dick today, but it's a little one.
There's no way this could get any more cringy.
Yo, and I'm vegan, so I recognize a baby carrot when I see one.
KSI brings out some gifts for Logan. He throws these Toy Story alien toys at him, a throwback to his infamous Japan Forest hat. But before he gets to finish talking, Jake Paul just ruins the entire bit.
No! What the fuck is up?
I don't think there's anyone on Earth, and
as hateable as Jake Paul. He's like that kid in kindergarten who just bullies everyone, but even the teacher is like, this kid is a nightmare. Sorry, Billy, but you're gonna keep getting bullied because I'm not getting paid enough to deal with this shit. Then they start pushing each other and the stage erupts in chaos. But fear not, ladies and gentlemen, Greg Paul is here to save the day. Look at his creepy old man face. What are you doing there? This is not about you. So the whole thing was just a giant shit show. But I would be lying if I said I'm not entertained. KSI is parading his inflated ego as the champ after easily defeating Joe Weller. Logan Paul is happy to have all the attention away from...
Who's this little squeaker in the party?
Jake Paul just gets to be in the spotlight and pull his usual Jake Paul shenanigans. And Deji, well, unfortunately, Deji's in over his head. Dude, even Ricegum and Keemstar, both of which are friends with Deji, do not have his back.
I don't think Deji's friendly, I don't know.
Yeah, because you all have to triple team me.
Jake Paul, like, dude, what? So listen, whatever happens, this is gonna be huge. I don't care about any of these people. Every one of them is more.
At least I actually can score.
They can all go suck a baby carrot as far as I'm concerned. But this is an important event for social media and YouTube as a platform in particular. Mainstream media still treats.
First of all, those ain't Mellows. The which one? Whose? And you think you're good?
It's gonna be lit. Wait, what? You're already going? Who are you going with? Jake Paul personally invited you? Are you kidding me? You know what? I'm gonna call Deji right now.
Y'all have to double team me?
Then we're gonna be on opposing
team. Okay, I see how it is. Then again, I dropped all the points on you.
I think he's on his lunch break. So what do you guys
think? Spam the threes. Spam the threes. Come on, spam the threes. Come on, spam the threes. Boy, you won't be one me, you won't. You won't, you toxic ass motherfucker. You won't, you won't, you won't. You won't, that's why you're just calling me names. You won't, you won't. Bet, let's go. You won't hop off and verse me. Bet, let's go. How about you get your freaking mic out of your throat? And what's wrong with that? And? Bruh, bro. Hello. Hello? Hello. Hello? Hello! Oh my God. Hello! Okay. I guess. I don't know why. How about now, when someone actually joins the stream? Sure. I don't care. Sure, let's go.